Hey, friend. Hey, friends. How are you guys doing today? I hope you're doing so, so well. And I am super duper excited because today we are going to the bins in Pittsburgh area. Jeremy and I have had a family emergency in Indiana. Jeremy's dad got COVID. He was hospitalized. He's doing better now. But he needs some help. He needs to be helped a lot because he was in the ICU for a long time. He has blood clots. Anyways, long story short, Jeremy and I are making the trip across the country to go help Jeremy's dad. Jeremy left with Otis a few days ago, and I am going now. I'm driving halfway, staying in Pennsylvania, and then coming the other half tomorrow. But that means that we're in Pittsburgh, and I am super excited to try out the bins here. But my car is literally packed with all of our inventory. Like, literally, we had to bring our business with us. We literally had to bring our business with us because we're going to be there for 4 weeks. So it's kind of packed in here. So I'm going to be very selective with what I pick up, but we're going to go in. I'll see if I can get footage. I don't know what this location is like. And I'm going to tell you guys what I find afterward. I'm super excited. So let's go in. Okay guys, I made it here to Indiana. I am currently in my mother-in-law's house. That is why the background is different. We are here to help take care of my father-in-law who just got out of the hospital with COVID. So we will be back here in Indiana for a few weeks actually. So you guys will be seeing a lot of varying backgrounds as I talk to you guys and hang out with you. So I don't have my normal lighting or things like that. So just please be kind as we go through this kind of odd transition of me still making videos for you guys, but I'm in a different location. So we'll figure things out as we go. But I wanna show you guys everything I got in the bins outside of Pittsburgh. Oh my goodness, these bins were so good. I found so many good pieces and I really want to go back. I was only able to be there for about 2 hours, but those 2 hours were so good and I found some amazing pieces and I'm very excited to show them to you. I found things, I think I might have even gotten a clip of me finding the Patagonia piece. I also found something from Off-White, which is crazy. And I also have some like Free People and Eileen Fisher. Like there were so many good brands. And I believe everything at this bins was $1.29 per pound. Pretty sure I got some footage of that too. So I'll hopefully have put that in the beginning of this video, but I found so many cool pieces. I'm very excited to show them to you. So let's hop into the haul. The first thing that I found here from this little Pittsburgh bins haul is this Harley Davidson quarter zip sweatshirt. So I think it's super cool. It says Harley Davidson on the front. It's just a gray colored sweatshirt. It's a man cut and it's from Zanotti in Butler, Pennsylvania, which I thought was funny because this is actually where Jeremy's aunt and uncle live and where I stopped halfway. I stayed the night with them in Butler, Pennsylvania. So that was kind of fun. And this is by Harley Davidson and it's in a size medium. So I found this and I just thought it was a nice piece. I thought that I would definitely pick it up for $1.29 per pound. I probably paid less than a buck for this. So I picked her up and hopefully I will resell for a good amount. Harley Davidson is pretty popular, but it just kind of depends on the style if it sells well for me. So I will put comps up on the screen during some time of me showing the piece. And hopefully that will show you guys what I hope to make from this piece or how much things like it are going for right now. So that should help you too in case you guys wanna be thrifting as well for profit. This next piece I found was really cool because I love picking up vintage pieces. They really speak to me. I think they're just really fun. I found this really cool vintage floral dress. It has shoulder pads at the top and then it comes down into a midi length. So I just thought it was a really pretty kind of t-shirt design. Very soft material for being vintage, very stretchy as well. And I just thought it was a really pretty color, really nice combination. This is by the brand Jenny, made in USA, and it is machine washable, which is nice. And what size is this? 20WP, looks like the size. So it is apparently a plus size piece, but again, a vintage size 20. So my guess is, oh, it does have stretch in the middle. So honestly, it could probably fit a size 20, 18 for sure. So I thought that was a really nice piece and I was excited to find that to pay maybe $1, $1.20 at the most for that. For all of these pieces that I found, I paid $43. So my car was very full before I stopped and it was a lot more full after. I couldn't really see out all of my windows, which was a little bit scary, but I mean, I've done it before as I've driven across the country. I wanted to not pick up that many things and I just couldn't help it. I closed that store down looking through its bins and I wanna go back. It was so good. This next piece that I found, this is actually a piece that I was intending to put back, but somehow it just got into my cart. So I don't really know anything about this brand. At the very least, I'll take it to a buy-sell trade location. But it is in my size too, so I guess I could try them on. But it is this pair of slink jeans. I've never heard of slink jeans, but I did like the wash on them. And it's kind of like a straight leg. It's really nice. It feels very thick. It reminds me a lot of how Madewell jeans feel. It's in a curvy fit and it's a size, 16. I thought it was a 14. But I thought that they were really nice. And I didn't have time to look up the comps for them. So I'll put those up on the screen at some point during me showing this piece to you guys. But I thought it was a nice pair of jeans. I don't know if the resale value is that much. I might try them on if they fit me. I might keep them. I might take them to buy sell trade. So there's a lot of options with this piece, but I thought these were really cute and I want to show them to you. This next piece that I found is so good, guys. This is one of my very favorite things I found in this bins. And that's because I love finding Eileen Fisher. Eileen Fisher is just a really classy brand and it sells really well for me. I found a couple Eileen Fisher pieces now in the bins and each time I buy them, I probably sell them for about $65 a piece. So it's a good turnaround for me. So I found this Eileen Fisher top in the bins and it is just a kind of a plain button down, just kind of nice top. But it's got this really great texture to it. It's a very like dark charcoal gray. It's a really nice texture. It's in a size small. Here is the Eileen Fisher tag for you so you know what you can look for. But this is just a really, really nice piece. So this is 90% rayon and 10% wool and it's dry clean only. So it's a really, really nice piece. But what was crazier is I was looking and I found this first. And then in the same bin, or maybe it was one bin over, I found the matching bottoms, which is so crazy. This one's tag is literally falling out a little bit, but it is by Eileen Fisher and it's in the same size, which is great. I hate it when I find pieces that are matching sets, but one's like a size medium, one's a size small, or just like a little bit of variance because it makes it a little bit harder to sell. But I found the matching pants. They're kind of more like a working, kind of more casual, businessy kind of look. But these are like kind of in a straight leg, I would say. And it's that same charcoal gray with a lot of texture to it too. So I was super jazzed to find these. This has pockets on the front and then it has a zipper as well as a little metal clasp to close the pants as well. So nothing wrong with either piece. And I found them both in the bin. I maybe spent $2 or $3 to get both of these items. And the comps hopefully will prove that was a good pickup because I was very excited to find Eileen Fisher in the bins. I always am. I love finding it. It's so exciting. Now this next piece I found, I have been wanting to find more like summer items, but if you find tank tops or anything at a normal Goodwill, it's kind of expensive. They're not super expensive, but to be able to resell something you find at a normal Goodwill, you usually need to find it for pretty cheap. And tank tops and things that are smaller like that with less fabric usually don't resell for as much. So finding them in the bins is the best alternative for me. But I found this really cute little knit pink top. I think it's really nice. It's a really cool, like, kind of like open weave knit, but it's just like very kind of thin, it's stretchy, and this is by American Apparel, and it's in a size small. And I know American Apparel, and they usually, I don't know if it's sold American Apparel, but I like American Apparel, so I'll give it a try, I'll give it a whirl. I just thought this was so cute, like a little cropped sweater tank top with a little bit of a V-neck. I thought this was really sweet, so I picked that up. I paid maybe like 25 cents for that at the most, so we'll see what the comps look like, but hopefully that sells well and sells quickly. Now, this next piece, I'm kind of on the fence about if I'm going to try to sell this or if I'm gonna give this to my sister. But I also found her two pairs of leggings in the same bins that I'm not gonna show you because I already gave them to her. I just found like some old navy leggings for her. But I found this beautiful, like kind of wrap style dress. It's from Lane Bryant. It's in a size 24. But it's got the most beautiful little fluttery sleeves. It's a really pretty floral pattern. It is a faux wrap style. So we have the overlay right here that kind of flaps over, and also the bodice, the top of this has kind of like a fold over as well with ruffles. It's really hard to show, but it is really pretty in person, and it has a zipper down the back. So it's navy blue, it has white and blue flowers on it. It's got a lot of ruffles, a lot of just like a lot of frills. I love it. I love this kind of dress even for myself. I think it's really pretty. And this is a little bit heavier. There's a lot more fabric here. It's lined and all that jazz. So I maybe paid $3-$4 for this, but I thought for a plus size piece, I'd love to pick up all sizes to sell on my Poshmark closet. And also, I think my sister could wear this, so we'll see if I sell it or if I give it to her, but I just thought this was a beautiful dress, so picked that up. This next piece I picked up because I wanted to try some new brands. You're gonna see a lot of new pieces in here, kind of brands I haven't tried before, but I heard recently somebody that picks up this brand all the time. I can't remember who it was. I watched a video, but she likes to pick up this brand, and it's called Jodiful. I don't know if that is the correct way to say it, but J-O-D-I-F-L, Jodiful. And it is this really cute, nice textured sweater. I love the white and the gray. It's really cute, really, really textured, really soft. And it has a little bit of a flare to the sleeve here on the end. And then we go into more of like a gray marled color down there. But it's just kind of like a regular crew neck at the top. And then we have a gray little stripe at the bottom. I just thought this was absolutely beautiful, and this is in a size large, so I picked this up, and again, the comps will be up on the screen for that. Next up, we have this little Calvin Klein poncho I picked up. I probably paid like a dollar or two for this, and it's just like a very, very boxy cut little Calvin Klein poncho. Not much to say about it, but it's in a size small medium, but as you can see, it is very big. I'm like usually a size large, extra large, and it definitely would fit me. So I'll probably mark this as one size for sure. But this is just a really nice piece. And I know a lot of people that watch my videos even love ponchos. They're just really easy to wear. So I picked that up for like a dollar or two, and hopefully we'll sell that one quickly too. Wow, this is a huge haul. I have so many pieces, but honestly, oh my gosh. Okay, we still have Patagonia coming your way, but I have to show you this piece because it's just so freaking amazing. I found this pair of jeans sticking out of a bin. The first thing I saw was the back, and I saw this and I was like, oh, that looks so familiar to me. And then I saw the front, and oh my gosh, I freaked out. Off-White is like a very nice brand. They're very expensive. They hold their resale value pretty well from what I've heard. I've never seen any Off-White anywhere, but Off-White is a very expensive brand. And it's seen on people like Hailey Bieber, like she loves Off-White, things like that. I don't know how to tell what size these are, so if you guys know this brand and you know where to find size tags, please let me know. They might have been cut out, but it has the little Off-White tag here and the little white tag right there. And then on the inside, I wanted to make sure that these were authentic, and they definitely are. They also have another tag on the inside right there. So these, I'm not sure what the style name for these are, but they're in pretty good condition. They are a light wash denim jean with white kind of like dip dyed at the bottom. And then they have this kind of cool, I think this is a very Off-White kind of thing to do with like kind of an embroidered, they're more like patches, an embroidered kind of patch looking thing going in the back. And the only thing that I think is not intentional about these pair of jeans is they have some fraying at the hem. So somebody definitely was a little bit too short maybe for this length of the jean, and they probably just kicked it as they walked or something like that. But for Off-White, I picked it up anyway because these are very expensive jeans. So they both have a little bit of fraying. That side has a little bit more. But I picked them up I'm very excited about them. This is an amazing brand. I'll have to put the comps up on the screen for you because I'm not sure how much they'll go for. I would assume they won't sell for less than $100. And I picked these up in the bins outside of Pittsburgh for, what, like a dollar or two at the most? So I was super excited about this. This is one of my best finds of all time, and I'm very happy about them. So that's why I keep on talking about them, because they're super exciting for me. So I found those and very jazzed. The next piece I found is a very, very trendy kind of Y2K piece, and it is this off-the-shoulder black velvet long sleeve top. It's cropped. It's also off the shoulder and has this kind of like faux feather top to it. It's by the brand Cache & Company. It's vintage. It's in a size medium. And it's just like very trendy right now. Like I could totally see somebody wearing this with some like high-waisted, really loose mom jeans. Like that's kind of the vibe right now. So I picked that up. I'm not sure what the comps will look like. I'll show those to you on the screen. My guess is maybe $15, $25. But anything will get me some profit. So happy to find that. And then this next piece is this vintage skirt that I found. And it's in a silkier fabric. And then it has this wonderful kind of really light paisley print to it. So there's a lot of blues and pinks going through it. But I thought it was really nice. The elastic is in really good condition. It's definitely really stretchy. This was by the brand Ms. Russ. But I picked this up too because when I was looking at the size tag, I found a union tag. So that is good. That makes me able to date it. This is in a size 20W. So with the union tag and with it being a plus size piece, I'm hoping to sell it pretty quickly. Definitely made before 1995. And it is a really pretty color. I think it's really cute. Honestly, with the stretchiness of the fabric, somebody that's bigger than a 20 probably could wear it. Somebody that's smaller than a 20 could wear it. But I thought it was really nice. So I picked that up for maybe 50 cents. And hopefully we'll sell that one again quickly. Quickly is the key here because we brought our entire business with us across the country. It is in bags in our basement right now and we need to get some stuff moving. So please go look at my closet. It is in the description. Make an offer on something if you find something you like. Because I need to move some stuff, guys. I really do. But this next piece I found is another tank top. And again, I like to pick up the tank tops right now because I need some more like summery pieces. But this is also 55% silk. Now this brand, again, I don't know if this is vintage. It's hard to tell on this one. And also, I don't know this brand, WDNY, but I thought this was a really cute top. It's very stretchy. It's a ribbed material and it has that slight V-neck. I just think this is a very cute basic, but I think it would look honestly even really cute with those off-white jeans. It's just very stretchy tank top, very cute. I liked it, so I picked that one up. And then we have this Altered State top. Altered State, I really like Altered State. I've only been into a store one time. I was introduced to it at Christmas time this year, so I've never heard of it before that, but I think it's a Christian mall brand, and I like them a lot. I like the stuff that they have. They only go up to a size large, I believe, sometimes an extra large maybe, but I found this size medium little top. It's in a pink ribbed, really soft, like cotton material. And then the sleeves are this really fun, billowy, very like Moroccan style sleeve, which I think is really fun. And then they have a cinch at the wrist. But I thought this was a really cute top. It's in a size medium. I think it definitely looks a little bit larger than a medium, but it's really pretty. And Altered State sometimes sells pretty well. A little bit more expensive retail pricing. So I was hoping that it would do well too on the resale market, but I guess we will see. I am now realizing the reason why I split these up into a couple videos, because this is a lot. There's many pieces of clothing here. This next piece I picked up is by Erin Featherston and it's the brand Edition, and it looked like a really good label, which is why I picked it up. And I think it might have been more of a designer piece. I'll have to double check again, but it's this really, really cute tank top. I love this. It's more of like kind of like an organza feel to it, but it has this really cute layered ruffled neckline. I think it's so fun. It almost looks like a collar, but I think it'd be really cute if you tucked this in and then just like wore this. And again, I wanted to pick up tank tops, so. But I love this neckline. I think it's super duper fun and it's got buttons going down the front in the contrasting black. So I picked this up for maybe 50 cents to 75 cents and I'll see what the comps look like, but I was happy to find that one too because I was picking up some really summery items, which is great. Speaking of summery items, I also have this little piece. This one does not have any tags. It doesn't have a size, it doesn't have a brand, but I still picked it up because it is too cute to leave. And it is this cute little like apron style dress. Judging by like the size of this, I would guess it's kind of a size medium. It almost looks handmade. I'm not really certain, but it's this really cute floral print with a straight across neck, and then the straps cross over in the back, and then they fasten right here with the cutest little heart buttons, which are so stinking sweet. So I love the style. I love the little buttons. I thought it was a super duper adorable piece. So I picked this up and I spent maybe, again, $1 on that, and I will have to maybe try it on, try to figure out the size for it. But I think this will be really cute for the spring and summer. Next up, we have this really cute little vintage dress. I love picking vintage things, guys. I just think they're so unique. This piece I picked out literally as I was walking out of the store, so it's very wrinkled right now, but it is this really cute little dress with this like really fun detailing around the buttons going down the front, a little cute little collar. I didn't know this because it was not buttoned when I found it, but it has that cute little cutout right there in the middle. I think that's kind of fun. This is by the brand Betsy's Things, and it's in a size 10. It has buttons going all the way down the front. I think it is a maxi length, and it's just a nice white dress. And then on the back, we also have that corseting, which is really popular right now. Really fun. I liked it. I picked it up for maybe $2. And for vintage things like that, we'll usually put them up for about $35. So if that's any different, I'll put it on the screen. But if it's not, then we'll probably do $35 on that. Then next up, I found a Free People top. And I love selling Free People. Sometimes it sells better than others. But at the very least, I can take this again to a buy-sell trade place. And they will definitely buy it. But I found this really cute little white crop top from Free People with like a longer sleeve and just like really fun lace detailing across the top. And there's the Free People tag, and this is in a size extra small. I thought this was really pretty. It'd be a really good kind of basic piece to match with a lot of fun bottoms, and I'm sure that's what they sold it for. So I picked that up, and again, another fun spring summer piece, and I maybe spent like a quarter for this. But Free People, you know, retails for so much, and sometimes the resale is there and sometimes it's not. I was happy to find Free People on the bins. I always am. And then this next piece I'm also very excited about, and it is this really cool Irish sweater. So I found another one of these very recently, and there's a lot of interest in these on the reselling market. This is 45% linen and 55% cotton. So like a linen blend. So a linen blend, really chunky sweater by Craig Dawn, and it's made in Ireland. So there is the tag. It looks vintage. It's very heavy. It feels really substantial. It's a really beautiful kind of like oatmeal color, kind of cream. Very chunky, very well made. Like this is very high quality, and this is in a size medium. So it definitely came from Ireland. It tells you what degrees Celsius to rinse it in. So that's cool. But I just thought it was a really nice sweater. I was very excited about it. So I picked that up, and this I paid up for probably a little bit more, just maybe $3 because it's heavier, but still definitely worth picking it up. And I think it's a really, really nice piece that'll definitely make somebody happy to have in their wardrobe. And then I found this Ella Moss sweater. I don't know anything about this brand, but I picked it up based on the style. It's just a really nice cardigan, and it's just an open, really pretty color, kind of like lavender, lilac, purple. So I picked that up, and that is in a size medium. So it looked like it was in good condition. It's very soft, so I picked that up. I also picked up this Ralph Lauren Sport little kind of mock neck sweater. It's vintage. It's really cool. I love mock necks when it just kind of goes straight down and doesn't have a seam going across the top. I think that's really nice. But it's a long sleeve. It's kind of this really nice thick ribbed material. But I love that. I think it's really nice. And this is in a size. This one's size tag has been ripped out, but if I had to guess from looking, it looks like a size large. Maybe a size medium. It's probably a size large. I would say a size large. And it's just in a dark gray color, but I liked that, so I picked it up. And then I picked up this matching suit set in a dark green, like emerald color. It's really fun. It's by the brand Le Suit. It's in a size 18. The green top has kind of these really fun, like almost floral crystal buttons on it. And then I also found the matching skirt that goes with it. And I just thought that was a nice pickup again, especially in like a plus size. I like to pick up a variety of sizes. So when I can find something that I think is cute in a larger size too, I always want to pick it up. And then I found this really cool vintage Penn State kind of ribbed sweatshirt, but it's by the brand Woolrich. So it's a vintage Woolrich piece in a size 2XL for men. And it is this really cool ribbed material, and it also has Penn State embroidered on it. So I picked that up because I love kind of picking up vintage more like sports material like that. I like to find things that people are gonna really connect with because they like the team, and I usually resell them pretty well. And then this next piece is another Free People top. I think this is absolutely darling. It looks tiny on screen, it really does. But this is in a size medium. It has kind of that ruching for the top, for the bodice, and then it has the cutest little ties for the sleeves. So it is a really cute little piece, and I think this might be an older Free People tag. It definitely looks older than the ones I usually see, but I still thought I'd pick it up again, spring and summer, and Free People again for maybe 25, 50 cents. Definitely was worth it for me. And then I found this vintage little skirt, and I'm very excited about it. This is a very trendy item right now. Little tennis skirts are super popular. I have never seen one in the wild, so I was very, very happy and excited to pick this up. I thought it was super fun. It has a brand on it, which I think is very interesting. It's IXSPA by Jamie Sadock. And this is in size 10. It looks very vintage to me. It's in good condition. There's no spots or stains on it, and I love the look of little tennis skirts. There is the brand. If you guys know anything about it, feel free to let me know. But I think it's really cool. I like it a lot. And then on the back too, we have a little button enclosure as well as a zipper. I picked that up and I paid maybe a dollar for it. And hopefully we can turn that around for maybe 35, maybe more for it. So I was very excited about that. I've never found one of those in the wild, so I was very happy. And then the next piece that I picked up was this really cute little blouse. I like the pattern on this. I like the coloring of it. It's a dark green, and then it has kind of a crossover in the front. And more of like a peplum style bottom. And then it has these buttons going down the front that are cloth covered. And I thought that was really sweet. It's really light. It has a little bit of a puff sleeve. And it also has kind of a cinch and elastic here at the wrist. So I thought this was beautiful. It's by Express. It's in a size large. And I paid maybe a dollar for that. So even if I take that to buy, sell, trade, it'll still be worth it. And then the next item that I picked up is this really, really light Lucky brand top. So it's a kind of a dark red, burgundy color, and it has some silver going through it. There's some metallic on it. It is all sheer. It's super pretty. And it also has a little button closure at the wrist. And I like the tie here at the top. So you can tie it into a bow at the neckline, which is really pretty. And this is in a size large. And I don't normally pick up Lucky brand. I just don't usually try to sell it, but I decided this would be worth a try because it was so little, so light. So I maybe paid like a couple cents, maybe a nickel, 10 cents for this. And again, we'll see how much it sells for. Now we have two more items. And as I always do, I like to save something fun for the end. But the second to last piece I also really like, it is this really fun vintage sweater top, and it's kind of like in a short sleeve, but it has all this really fun design throughout it. So it's raised and it has some flowers, and my favorite part are all the hearts. We have hearts at all the hem areas, so we have kind of heart designs right there, the sleeves, and all the way across the bottom, as well as on the back, and just really fun knitting designs all throughout. And it's in a beautiful kind of light purple color, lavender, a little bit lilac. There's no size on this, and I would guess that it's in a size more like large, extra large. So there isn't anything on the back, it's just the little design across the bottom, but I thought this was super cute, so I picked that up for maybe a dollar or two, and I brought it across the country with me to resell from Indiana. So this very last piece that I'm going to show you is this super amazing Patagonia piece. It's in a quarter button down. It is a dark blue, kind of almost purpley color sweater. I'm very, very happy that I found this. This is one of my favorite things I picked up. And it is in a size extra, extra large. And it has their classic kind of cinchel. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Cinchel? Cinchel shape, where it has a little pocket here on the front, has the Patagonia label, and then we have the Patagonia on the inside as well. I love the kind of green accent colors, and it has a seam going across the front. It's in good condition. It's super nice and fluffy and really cute. I love finding Patagonia, and this is just like one of my best finds of all time. If you guys follow me on Instagram, then you would have seen this already on my stories. If you don't already follow me on Instagram, this is my plug. Go follow my Instagram down below. It's in the description. But I just thought this was so cool. I love this sort of stuff. Has the little classic button closure clasps right across the top. I think it's so sweet. I'm very tempted to keep it for myself. It would be a little bit large on me, but also I love the oversized look. So I love this piece and I could not believe I found this. The comps will be on the screen during sometime while I'm showing this piece, but at least $50 is my guess for this piece. And I paid at the most $2 for it, so that is a good turnaround in my opinion. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all these pieces that I thrifted in Pittsburgh. I hope you guys enjoyed coming into the store with me. I actually got a picture for my thumbnail in the store, which is crazy because there are 4 people in that Goodwill outlet. I am so used to my Goodwill outlet where you literally switch bins every 45 seconds. This was the most chill bins experience of my life. It was so fun, so relaxing, and I found so many good pieces, so I would love to go back. If you guys want to see me go back, make sure you guys let me know down below, give this video a like, and also make sure you are subscribed. If you are not already subscribed, then please hit that subscribe button. You can also hit the notification bell to be notified every time I make a new video, but I'm going to be here in Indiana for a while, so I'll be showing you guys some content from the good old Midwest. I'm excited to do it. I hope you guys liked today's video. I hope you guys like watching my comfort with me's. And I hope you guys are doing amazing. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. And until the next video, bye.